pride. Proverbs 18 verse 18. Pride goeth before destruction, and an haughty spirit before a fall. This is one of the most quoted Bible verses that we hear all the time. It is something we have heard people say, but I don't believe that we understand the true nature and the deeper part of pride. We don't even know the different ways pride can come into one's life. We believe that it is until someone flaunts their wealth before we can say they are proud. Pride is not one of the sins that will just come out in you suddenly. Pride has to be conceived or incubated in a person before coming out. Pride can be sown into one's life and then bring its fruit at due time. We need to understand what pride is so that we can know when we are being proud, arrogant, or when we are not. What the Bible says about pride is that it is always what comes before destruction. Pride is always there to bring destruction. The opposite of pride is humility. It is not all the time that pride is evil or sin. There is a kind of pride that is just about being appreciative of one's achievement, and this pride will not be a sin if one acknowledges God. It is not a sin to take pleasure in your achievements. It is not a sin to be proud of the good things you have done. But it will be a sin if you are doing this without humbling yourself before God by acknowledging the fact that He made it possible. What I am saying is that if you are boasting about your achievement without acknowledging God, it is a sin. There is also another kind of pride. This is synonymous with arrogance. This is an act of using one's position or achievement to oppress others or to see others as useless. If you are boasting about your achievements without thanking God, or you are oppressing others with your achievement, what you are doing is evil in the sight of God, and that is a sin. The second thing I want us to address is the reason why pride will always go before destruction. Pride is not something that will make one listen to others. When one is proud or arrogant, they are placing themselves above everyone. Pride is showing that you are above everyone, and you only have the right to correct others, and no one can correct you. Pride is an act of showing that you know it all, and that you don't have to listen to the advice of others. If you are like this, you don't like other people correcting you. You don't want them to tell you what to do. The truth is that you are proud. Pride will always come to play and lead someone into destruction. When God tells you not to do something, when God warns you that you should not take a specific path, and you continue on because you think you have the power to control the outcome, it will lead to your destruction. That is why the Bible says, pride will always go before destruction. There is nothing anyone will do except repent. If pride is in their lives, they will be destroyed. Are you proud? Are you arrogant? Many people have lost their wealth because of pride. Many people have lost their marriages because of pride. Some people have lost their jobs because they cannot be corrected. They allowed pride in them. And I can tell you that many pastors have lost their callings because they allowed pride to overtake them, and they didn't see it on time. What we need to do is look deep into our lives and identify the seed of pride that has been planted in us and uproot them. We need to be able to know when pride is creeping into our lives. We need to know what to do when pride is creeping in also. For us to know how to deal with pride in us, we need to know how the seed can be sown in us. I will tell us some shocking ways by which pride can enter into a life. Pride will always enter in a way that you cannot know, and it will destroy one before they know. What are the ways the seed of pride is sown into a life? Number one, through people. Many pastors have allowed the church members to sow the seed of pride in them. They have allowed them to use their humility to bring out pride in them. Many people will say they respect you, but what they are doing is sowing the seed of pride in you. Many pastors have allowed the respect from the church members to bring out pride in them. People are one of the ways the enemy sows pride. People can exalt you and put you on a pedestal. We hear the term celebrity pastors. That term never made sense to me. The main focus in any church should be Jesus Christ. Jesus is the one who should be exalted, not a man or a woman. Number 2, your humility. I know this will be very strange to many of us, but I want you to know that your humility can make you proud. When you are being humble to show people that you are humble, it is like forcing humility out of you. When people say something good about you, you show them that you are not proud and you reply with humility. That is not true humility. If you are humble, you don't need to force yourself to show it. It will be part of you, and it will be to the glory of God. If we don't understand this, what I am saying is that showing people that you are humble so that you can be praised for it is an act of pride. Your humility can mean arrogance. You need to stop that if you are doing that. You are showing the world that you are humble, and you want to be praised for your humility. That means you are not humble before the Lord, and that is something dangerous, because you will be pulled down. Proverbs 11 verse 2, when pride cometh, then cometh shame, but with the lowly is wisdom. Romans 12 verse 6, be of the same mind one toward another. Mind not high things, but condescend to men of low estate. Be not wise in your own conceits. Number 3, the devil. Have you ever looked at the things you have, your achievements? And are you tempted to think that even without God, you would have achieved the same? You look at your cars, your house, and the family you have, and you think maybe if you had not been a Christian, you would have gotten all of these too. Look, if that thought comes into your heart, it is the devil sowing the seed of pride. If you do not clear it away, it will grow, and you will think you achieved all these things by yourself. The devil will always speak to the heart of people and make them look at what they have achieved. If you dare do this thing, if you look at what you have achieved and you say you have done it yourself, or you think maybe if you had not been a Christian, you would have achieved the same, you are setting yourself up for failure. There is another person like this man who exalted himself because of his kingdom. This person is King Nebuchadnezzar. He went to the roof of his palace and saw his kingdom and gave glory to himself. What happened to him? Daniel 4 verse 29 to 32. At the end of 12 months, he walked in the palace of the kingdom of Babylon. The king spake and said, is not this great Babylon that I have built for the house of the kingdom by the might of my power and for the honor of my majesty? While the word was in the king's mouth, there fell a voice from heaven, saying, O King Nebuchadnezzar, to thee it is spoken, the kingdom is departed from thee, and they shall drive thee from men, and thy dwelling shall be with the beasts of the field. They shall make thee eat grass as oxen, and 7 times shall pass over thee, until thou know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and giveth it to whomsoever he will. This that was spoken against the king happened instantly. I am talking to you today, my brothers and sisters, that pride is not good. The punishment that comes with pride is destruction. It is not a good thing to allow people to sow pride in you, or allow the devil to sow pride in you. You need to fight it by humbling yourself before the Lord. James 4 verse 7, so humble yourselves before God. Resist the devil, and he will flee from you.